Today, I am going to take you through, finally, a technical demonstration of our new app, Shapes. This free app for our console is the first in our YetiCut app suite. And we designed it so that users don't need a computer anymore to cut simple shapes on SmartBench. It can be used on any console and on any SmartBench. In this demo, I'll take you through the workflow for using shapes, and then we'll use it to start a cut in just 2 minutes, and then we'll have a look at the finished job. Let's get into it. Shapes is a single screen cutting application, and we designed it with a workflow that helps get from start to finish as quickly as possible. We start in the top left-hand corner and move along the functions, ending with the Go button in the bottom right. The Home button, Home SmartBench as standard, and the final position of the laser marks where to align the home corner of the sheet with the machine. This Open button opens a previously saved configuration if you want to repeat any previous jobs quickly. The Material Tool Selection button picks out which material you're cutting and the tool you're using. The Shape button changes the shape on the canvas. Shapes currently supports a number of basic geometries, including squares, rounded rectangles or slots, circles, and straight lines. And this will grow. Shapes can be rotated at intervals of 90 degrees. And for each shape, you can pick 4 different toolpath offsets, inside, outside, or on the line, and pocketing. The Setup button defines depth parameters for your job, including cutting depths and tabs. Note here that the step downs are calculated automatically, but it can be overridden, and tabs can also be switched on or off. The canvas is here for you to enter your shape dimensions, and we show the datum values here if you want to accurately position your shape on the stock. Note these colored bumpers at the 4 edges of the canvas, which are incredibly helpful. These bumpers will turn red and flash if cutting the shape would put the machine out of bounds, either if the shape is too large or if the datum is too close to the edge. These jog buttons move the machine in X and Y axes, and when you're happy, you use the Set button to set your datum. The Go to Datum button will flash if the head is not at the saved datum position, and it will stop flashing when the head has arrived. For shapes, we've introduced rapid probing to save time, so we can now set the Z datum with a single button press. Before starting a job, you can simulate your job in air before running it, and that does a single boundary walk using the cutter as the visual marker. You can save your job as a configuration to be repeated again with this Save button, and when you're ready to run the job, you just press Go. Okay, so that was the theory. Let's have a go. Into shapes. I'll start off by homing that machine. So there's no real difference to the homing here, as I said, other than when it's finished, it's going to move to a specific location, very close to the home. And it's going to use its laser to point. And that's really helpful because that's telling me where I want, you can just see the crosshair there, where I want to position stock if I'm using a full sheet. Sorry, I just hit you there. All right, so first things first, let's select our material. I'm going to be using birch here. And I'm going to be using my 8mm two flute down cut. I want a circle now. Yeah, I'll stick with a rectangle again. I'm going to use all of the prompts to remind me what I wanted, so I want 100. I will do the key presses just so that we can do a fair analysis on timing. I'll make this 10 this time. Could rotate a couple of times, but I'm happy with that. And this time, I think I want my, I think I'll have it on the inside of the line. Yeah, cool. Right, so next into Z depth setting, it's 12mm sheet. Great, and I want to punch through a millimeter below the stock, just breaking into the spoil board there. Tabs, yes please. Auto depth, yes please. I don't want to have to calculate how deep is optimal. And I want to now position the beginning of where the shape's going to go. So I'm going to adjust that very, very slightly. I want to move it over a little bit. And I'll set it there. happy with that. Right, better just check that the old cutter's gonna land in the right place. So we're using our fast probe there. And see how fast that was. Literally is fast probing. Happy with Z, happy with X and Y. Let's do a simulation. So it's using the cutter here to actually draw out what that the bounding box is. And I think I'm good. I'm not going to save this job. I could do it if I wanted. But now I'm going to go cut. And off we go. So while it's cutting there, I'm going to start speaking a bit to this camera. You'll notice I didn't put the dust shoe plug in, so it's a little bit messy, but yeah. Okay, so while this is cutting, I'll give you a little bit of technical background. Let's recap. I've just spent a couple of minutes starting the job without a PC because I've only needed to specify the size of my shape, where it's going to go, the cutter I'm using, and the material for the stock. I have not in any way entered any of the usual machining details like speeds and feeds. If it was a pocket, I wouldn't have to specify step over or tab distances or anything like that. And that's because Shapes already knows. So how does it know? It knows because we have done months of testing to understand how our cutters perform for different materials and how they should be used. And all of that test data has been packaged up so that Shapes can access it. Currently, it supports up to 30 cutters in 10 different materials. And for customers who want to use their own cutters, you may have spotted a link to the toolbox in the lobby there, which is a forthcoming app. And that's going to allow customers to upload data for their own cutters, which they'll then be able to use with Shapes a little bit later. We don't have a release date on that just yet, but it is coming. Whilst it's cutting, or while this has been cutting rather, there are some things that you might not be aware of. So you saw that it's doing tabs, but it does also automatically throw in a finishing pass. Sorry, I don't know whether you heard any of that, but the cut's finished, so let's have a look. So yeah, I'm just gonna move the head away from the job and we'll have a quick look at what it's done. It's a second rectangle over here. We can see it's got the tabs there. It's using a 3D tab profile and it's done the finishing pass and it's looking smooth. I'm really happy with that. So yeah, there you go. That is Shapes from start to finish. I really hope that this tech demo has been useful in understanding the power. We're really changing the workflow here with CNC. You know, I have not used the PC. I've just literally come to the SmartBench and I've asked SmartBench to crack a shape out all you know, from just one screen. And I've got to say it does, I'm going to sound like a broken record, but it does feel like a power tool now. All right, hope it's been helpful. Thanks a lot. Have fun.